I'm recording.
See, y'all don't want to say nothing when I'm recording.
I'm gonna call my lawyer.
Call your lawyer.
Nah, you don't know about that. That's a buck.
Fellas. What is that? I call a lawyer.
Was Carla there or no, Jesse?
No.
Oh, I think okay. You guys told. I think one of you guys told me about that story at the team.
Romeo probably told you about him.
Maybe.
Podcast, back in it again.
Okay.
Gorgeous man.
Damn.
Gorgeous. Okay.
No, I'm not notorious, but I gotta be IG. Oh, Biggie. Yo, no Biggie.
All right, keep going. Come on. That was a bridge. That's not even a hook.
16. Keep it going.
I was just giving you guys some bars, man.
A-A-A-T-A-T on the street. The real one.
Vandy can't help you.
Bars, not SARS.
Over my hot dog.
I really wanted to do this podcast yesterday because my energy was better. I'm happy because I'm on vacation today, so my energy is correct. But my dignity and my pride would have been more intact because I'm so sad that the Lakers lost.
We're going to get into that, but hey, that's a broken heart for all of us, though. We all a little sad about that.
Honestly, I was sick.
But were you wearing your hat?
I was wearing my hat. I wore my Leave a Legacy shirt that I got when we went to watch the game at the Rose Bowl parking lot. It was my grandmother's 83rd birthday. Shout out, Grandma TK. That was the first time I had seen my grandmother since, like, February. Ooh. And it was on her birthday. The Lakers was going to win the championship. She's a big-time Lakers fan from back in the day. And since Jerry West, and I just knew they were gonna win, and they let us down.
Damn! So she saw Jerry West, but she saw Jerry West's 8 finals appearances, 10 finals appearances, and 9 losses.
Yeah.
Damn, that's tough.
So I was really sick. I was pissed.
My wife asked me, "Are you okay?" And I'm like, "Yes, just watching this game. I'm sitting in the fetus position." Just watching the game from the third quarter, I just didn't have a good feeling the whole time, and it made me sick to my stomach.
It's your fault. So we have an Instagram page.
Why'd they lose, Andy?
Yeah, we have an Instagram page, and I post the question: who's going to win tonight's game? Lakers or are the Lakers going to win tonight's game? Jesse answered, and he said, "Nah." And guess what happened? They lost. So it was your fault.
Funny man. He always wants to be funny. And guess what? It wasn't funny. They lost in the Black Mamba jerseys because of you and Danny Green and Kuzma and Markieff Morris.
All light skins, pretty much. All the light skins.
All the light skins.
Just taking the L's. Andy, you with us, Andy? You got the braids.
Got the braids back.
Got the braids, yeah. It had to get them back, you know?
Okay. For those who are listening for only audio, you're going to have to tune into the YouTube just to check out this man's brew. Or check out the Instagram
show us your crown. Hey.
Oh.
Okay.
Did you get the do-rag?
No, and the girl told me to get it, but
come
nah,
on,
I
got man.
It. The girl told I can't be
Tyler Hero out here, you know?
Why not?
Wave check. You got to make sure the waves are right. What do you say? I don't got waves, but, you know.
How was your heartbreak, Andy? Did you take it well?
I was sad. My wife was a little bit more emotional than I was. She's really into it. So she was
really.
Like, she was jumping up and down, and she was like, I was just looking at her on the side, like she was sitting on the couch, and she was just like twitching up and down, like she couldn't stop moving. She was like, Andy, how can you just sit there and just be still? She was all emotional about it, but I didn't get all crazy about it until the last play or the last possession. I wasn't upset at Danny Green. I was not upset at Danny Green. I know a lot of people are because that was a great play. I'm more upset at Markieff Morris. I think that was just an unintelligent play, IQ play at that time and moment. And I think that he'll learn and grow from it, but he could have just simple jump shot. AD was in the post. He could have got a rebound, or he could have drove in, layup. 6 seconds on the clock. He could have done a lot.
Anything.
I think
he had the right mindset. I think it just didn't pan out to what it was going to be. And Bam was really, really boxing out. He kind of pushed AD. I think if AD had better position, he may have been able to catch that. But if he would have caught it, it would have been a game over play anyways.
I mean, Yeah, but I think there were so many other possibilities that could have. He just threw the ball away. It was a bad play. But I know a lot of people are mad at Danny Green. You know, I feel bad for him, but
it is what it is. This man was trending on Twitter.
Let's talk about the light skin slander.
What did they say? I didn't get to check on it. What did they say?
So there was a link that somebody posted. I think both of you guys probably had to have seen it. It's like buy Danny Green's jersey, and it went straight to a trash can.
Fat kid deals, yeah. Yeah.
His
jersey trash cans too, right? Two trash cans said yeah. Markeith and go to the locker room.
See, that's all bad. So and then the other one was like his jersey says how many more, right? And then it said 14. How many more shots are he gonna miss? And this is 14.
Even Snoop got on his head too, man. Like, pay this man, what is it, $15 million to make wide open shots, and he can't do it.
That's the thing, is that that's why we got him, is to make that shot.
And yeah. Like, he was wide open. Andy, I've seen Andy make shots like that at the gym, eyes closed. Andy's done plenty of those shots to hit the game winner.
Supposedly, it's some behind the scenes stuff going on.
He had his finger, right?
Something. So we'll see.
Blevins knows all the tea.
What was the thing that you had sent us, Blevins? That was LeBron mad that they had set up everything already for them to win? Is that what I read?
We won't get into it on air. But they planned to win last night.
I did read that the NBA had said that the officials missed some calls where the Lakers should have got throughout the game.
It don't matter, man. Either you win or you don't. Like, it ain't like you can go back and play. You know what I mean? Like, I get that they do that, the last 2-minute report, like with whatever blown calls, missed calls, all that. But it don't matter. They took the L, and tomorrow they better bring it or else they're going to catch these paws.
I mean, they have to. I mean, game 7 is a toss-up. And if they go to a game 7, it doesn't do well for, like, LeBron's legacy also. I think he does take another dent in it. So he definitely has to come out and ball, which he did. Like, man, the dude was smacking.
He played great.
Yeah.
He played great. KCP showed up. The problem is nobody else did. And I already had Lakers in 6.
So did I.
I wanted them to win in 5 just for all those other reasons that I mentioned, and they should have won in 5 too.
Yeah, what bothers me is that it gives people more of an opportunity to bash on LeBron that he should have took the shot. But I mean, I feel like that's the play that got lined up by Vogel, and you know, it was the right play though. That's the thing. I mean,
yeah, he had 3-4 people on him.
Like, yeah, it was the right play. I think he did take a little bit of responsibility where he said, "I feel like the pass could have been better," and it could have been. It was a little slow and it was a little off, and it could have been a little bit more straight and fast. But
there was nobody within 15 feet of Danny Green. I don't care if the pass went into the back court. The man was wide open.
I'm just playing devil's advocate. I'm trying to be a fan here.
I'm kind of sketchy too, because Vegas, you know, Vegas is pretty smart when it comes to that. So they had the Lakers -7.5. So that's a heavy, heavy, heavy favorite. And then going into game 6, they're only
lost by 3 or 4.
Yeah.
They lost by 3.
So they would have had a win by 6 or more.
And LeBron kind of had a nice look at the end too. I don't think he needed a double pump fake. He had that 1.5 seconds.
Air ball.
Yeah, I feel like that was a good shot. That's probably the best shot you can ask for in that situation. He didn't need to pump fake.
Why you interrupt me, Andy?
I'm sorry.
Okay.
I'm just kidding. I was saying.
You were saying.
Speaking of MAGA.
No. I was saying that Vegas odds has them tomorrow's game at 5, Lakers at 5, which is just sketchy. So I'm scared for tomorrow too, which I hope Lakers just win.
Lakers, they'll win tomorrow. I'm sure, you know, they got death threats from people in LA. And then Kuzma will not be allowed back in LA. Danny Green will not be allowed back in LA.
That's already the case. It's funny, though, because Staples Center and LA Live put out a statement saying that they won't be televising the game, so don't come down there.
Oh, because there's riots if they lose.
People were already going to come down there and celebrate regardless of that. And yeah. They were like, don't you know? First of all, we Laker fans. Second of all, we're from LA. And third, it's been 10 years. We ain't listening to that.
Yeah. They'll be out there.
Jesse, you going to be out there?
You guys,
quick trip on the PJ.
Am I there or the MAGA rally? Which one?
Both. Both. Two things can be true.
Both.
Yeah. I'm going to be on the bus.
Wait, we all watched the debate last week, though, right, too?
I watched a part of it, yes.
Like I watched a lot more of that debate than I did the Trump and, what's his name, Joseph?
Biden. Why, because you can tolerate Kamala and Pence more?
No, I think on it, well, first of all, I had the time. I had the time to really sit there. And then I felt like that was history, and I wanted to witness it. I wanted her to do really well, and she really did. I feel like what I always like to say is when other people go low, you go high, and she went high, and she did an amazing job. I think that she answered her questions well. Pence was definitely being an a-hole a lot, and that's what I'm saying. She went high, and she still attacked. She had really good substance and context to like everything that she had, the questions that was asked. I feel like she represented herself, black women, women in general, and the country. And but, you know, Twitter said otherwise, and we know who Twitter was, you know, what type of people were on Twitter. But I enjoyed it, man. That was one of the first times I really, really tuned into a debate.
Did she really go high, though? Because she was throwing shade. She had all the looks, the gestures, all of that.
But I feel like that's... I mean, forgive me if I'm wrong, but I just feel it. Like that's natural. Number one, as a woman would do that either way. Number two, she's black, and she had to like show her true self. Like that's one thing that I feel like she did really well, is like she didn't hold back. And I feel like if anything, it should empower the people that are looking to vote for her and Biden, just Joseph, because like this is the real. This is who she is. This is what they're gonna. That's what who they should expect. So if they do get into office, then hey, you know, she showed you exactly who she was back then. So ain't nothing new.
Yeah, Jesse, what'd you think about it?
Well, funny thing is, like I said, I ran into it towards the end because you had mentioned it in the group chat, like, hey, y'all watching this? So then I had got right to the good part. So I was about to take a shower. So I put it on in the shower. So I'm like, all right, let's watch this. So I started watching it. Put it on
TV in his bathroom.
No, I put my phone up there, and I was watching it.
And then
my wife was like, my wife was in there. She was like, you really
where?
In the shower.
With you?
Yeah.
Doing
she
what?
She was like, not that she was washing herself. We was taking.
And you
shower.
And you were paying attention to that over that. Something wrong with you, boy. But anyway,
well, he did say he tuned in at the best part, so he's not.
He didn't say which best part, but go ahead, keep going.
So I put it there, and she told me, she made a comment like,
"You put what there and where?" Okay, go ahead, keep going.
Put the phone on the wall.
Okay, let's see.
And she was like,
"To the wall."
She was like, "You're really into this, huh?"
Come on, man. Come on, man.
Oh my gosh.
Let's keep it BG.
And then and I was like, "No, I'm here for the jokes. I'm here for the comedy." So she was watching, she ended up getting out. So I'm watching it. And that's when the whole fly went on this head. Right? So then I thought something was on my phone because I'm in the shower. So I'm like, "What's on my phone?" So then I put my phone and I zoom out of it and I still see the fly. I'm like, "Oh, that guy got a fly on his head." And then remember I texted you guys right then. I texted you guys in the shower like, "This guy got a fly in his head." I didn't think anybody was going to pay attention to it or see it, right? They made all these memes on there. But anyways, the whole thing of what I saw, like, she was very well-spoken. I really... I think she had some good points. I think they both dodged some questions. Mm-hmm. They were really dodging.
They're politicians, questions. Of course.
Yeah, I know. Their dodging skills are like kind of crazy. I just felt like some of those questions weren't answered, but I understand, like, yeah, they're politicians and they're supposed to answer a certain way. But it was way better than the first one. I think it was more entertaining and more, I gained more knowledge. And she was rooting for Biden. Like she was writing for him. Like, hey,
for real,
for him. Like it was all about him. And it's crazy because a lot of that focus that's on her, she's deflecting it towards him or towards the bigger picture of it. It's like, hey, this is gonna be your man. This is gonna be your man. Like, trust me, this is gonna be your man. So, but I think she has some good points. Like, I liked her. I really, really liked her. But overall, great.
It sucks that you're not gonna vote for them, huh?
You know, Kanye has my vote, man.
Oh my god.
He put out merch right after that.
And the merch is booming too.
Yes,
He posted like the stats or whatever.
Well, I think that first thing he made $840,000.
It doesn't surprise me. I should not be surprised.
He had over 6,000 orders. 6,800 different orders.
Kanye has the unlock from like just money making. That's merch nuts.
Unlock, buddy.
At some point, I'm just not gonna buy merch no more. I was already there. And like, I saw the link. I sent it to you guys, but I didn't even click on it because I was like, I'm not gonna buy nothing.
I saw the link. Like, I like the hat, the Kanye 2020 Vision hat. That was pretty dope.
I like the stuff.
Yeah, because it looks super comfortable. Like it was thick.
Buy because of what it represents.
Yeah, I didn't purchase any of that.
Promise. You sure?
Promise.
What does it represent? Let me ask that.
What we've been talking about for the last several months, like supporting his running for office when he ain't even really on the ticket in the vast majority of states, and he ain't really for real about this whole thing.
Yeah, it's taking a vote for where it could go to where it matters.
Yeah, man.
That's true.
Our stuff is already messed up. I don't need him to mess it up even more, at least not right now. But for me in the debate, same thing, like, The Fly stole the show. It's crazy because I wouldn't consider myself really political at all. But you know, in the state of our society, like, you got to know what's going on. So I watch a lot of the, you know, news channels and whatnot and see what's going on and stay informed with everything. And The Fly was on every single news channel, every single tweet. It was crazy that The Fly is who everybody was talking about over them two.
there was a stock, their stock number is or name is FLY, and I guess I went up like 6% the next day.
Yo, that's funny, dude.
Yeah,
so there must be like stock hype beasts.
There
must be some stock hype beasts. Yeah, that fly was funny, man. There was a lot of memes also because I think there was a Dodger that caught a ball. He reached out for that ball and they had him catching the fly. It's hilarious. Y'all ready to get into some hip hop?
Yeah.
So Andy brought up a great question and he wanted to know our top five dead or alive list. So, I wanted some clarity from this list. So this is just our favorite. So I'm just going by my personal favorite. I don't know what you guys are going through. These are just mine. Probably gonna be some most random names on here, some of them that probably belong there, some of them that probably do not, but it's just like if there's five artists that I have to listen to every day, it'll probably be these five, like no change. But
what are they?
You want me to go first?
Yeah.
Oh, I already gave my intro, huh? Might as well.
Mm-hmm.
Let me pull up these notes because I don't remember.
Yeah, and then we said that these are not.
I'm doing mine off the cuff.
Yeah, we said that these are not. No particular order also.
No order.
All right. So mine is going to be Tupac.
Sorry.
We were born in Compton. He was raised. That's all he played as a kid. Like every day as a kid growing up, all I would hear is Tupac. So growing up or as I got older, I would listen to it. I'm like, dang, now I saw why Pops liked it. And to this day, I still listen to it. So I think it's more impactful from my life, like my past, that makes it relevant. But yeah, Tupac, then Jay-Z, because I think, you know, the 2000s to the 2000 and to now, been killing it. Anything that he comes out with, we're always looking for. Everything that he's done is just, he can't miss, besides Magna Carta. But I still like that album. I like that album. I like it.
By the way, I laughed when you said Tupac because I know that's the only West Coast artist that you really mess with like that. That's why I laughed.
And the funny thing is, I was thinking the same thing, and I almost put Ice Cube in my list because I love him too. And but he's a close one too. I think my third one is Joe Budden. I listen to him a lot of the.
I laughed at Tupac. I'm angry at Joe Budden.
A lot of high school music, you know, during high school and till 2009, that was some good stuff. That was some good mood music. My fourth one will be Nas. I think Nas is good because, yeah, I'm still like on this East Coast, but he's swaggy with the lyrics, and this is just rappers, and I think he could rap on any type of beat. He's really smooth with it, and he's very, he has his own vibe. And then my last one will be Pusha T. I love that guy. I already, like I said, I've talked about this guy many of times of just how kind of the success that he's had from the clips and even to his life now still being successful. But man, his mixtapes, his albums, he doesn't come up with commercial albums, but his albums are dope. And I think even having that Timberland produced album and saying, hey, Timberland, I want all your B-side cuts. Like, I don't want no pop, like, or no commercial stuff. Give me all your B-side stuff. Just to have an artist that's consistent with the music and that type of genre that he wants to stick to, I applaud that. So Pusha T.
Nice list. I'll go second. My list is all East Coast. No West Coast. I'm sorry, Blevins. I know you're disappointed. I'll just name the five that I have, and then I'll talk a little bit about them. So I have Jay-Z, Notorious B.I.G., Nas, Kendrick, and Pusha T. Jay-Z, because he's one of the first rappers that I ever listened to where I've paid attention to lyrics and like rhyme patterns. And I think that he's one of the first ones that got me inspired to even put down lyrics on a piece of paper and try to like mimic him. And obviously he has so many great albums. Even his bad ones are good, and his good ones are great. That's the way I look at it. And Notorious B.I.G., I had to really
Hold on. Andy and I, Andy had the Fade to Black DVD. We cried on that DVD. We've watched it multiple times together.
You say cry.
That was the saddest moment, I swear to you, during that time. I thought he was never coming back.
And now look at him. He got like six albums afterwards.
Hey, maybe I didn't mean more. To interrupt you, but I just had to shoot that out there. That was
funny. Nah, it's all good. And Notorious, like, I had to go back and listen to his Ready to Die album. And then when I did, I remember I went through like a whole month where I didn't put that album down. And I just went through a story like every single time. And I got infatuated with the way he was able to like tell a story and just be and be lyrical at the same time. So a lot of people could tell a story and not be lyrical. And I feel like he embodied what it is to be like an MC. And then also he took us through a journey from a kid in Brooklyn. Like if I'm in the West Coast, Southern California, and I have no idea what Brooklyn is like or New York is like, I listened to that album and I know exactly what it was like in his area, in his demographic, in his, like, you know, wherever he was at in Brooklyn. Like, I knew exactly what was going on. And that was because he was able to tell me through his stories. Nas, same thing, I think, as Jesse. Is just a lot of people put him in his top, but I think he's in the top of a lot of people's lists only because he did it his way. Like, he could have steered off and did a lot of commercial stuff. He could have steered off and went and... he stuck to like the essence of what put him in the game, and that was just rapping. He could just rap, and obviously he's had like good albums, bad albums, classic albums, and I think that when you come out with an album like he did, you know, right off the jump, like, it's kind of hard to come back to that. And I think that he's been able to maintain like and excel at the same time. So Nas for sure. Kendrick, being, you know, in my early 20s, first listening to him, being just a kid in Southern California, tapping into like exactly the things that I was probably dealing with as a minority, having friends that were black, hip hop. Like, I'm like, dude, this kid is talking to me. Like, I feel like this is me, and he's putting it in raps, and he was nasty with it. And, you know, I pray that he still comes out with one more album, which I think obviously it's on the way. I'm always looking forward to him. Seen him so many times live, like just an amazing talent. So I genuinely love Kendrick. I feel like he is for the people. He really loves his fans. Like, he's just one of those people where we don't get, we can't get enough of him, and we want more of him. Yeah. And then we got Pusha T. Same thing that Jesse said. I feel like he's just consistent, man. He's a lyricist. He can give you a Coke 16 in a hot second. He drops a bar every single time. I just feel like he stuck to his lane. He if anything, we can study his career patterns and find success. If anybody just wants to like see what success looks like, he's done it his own way. And I feel like his career speaks for itself. So for sure, Pusha T. And those are my top five, dead or alive.
First of all, I'm very thankful that you did not put Joe Budden in there. So thank you. Thank you, first and foremost.
He's probably a good six. Kendrick is my six. Kendrick is my six, probably.
No, hold on. And Blevins can get this off. Blevins can get this off. No, the reason why I wouldn't put him on there, because I feel like he spoke to me in a certain time in my life, and I always hold those moments like to near and dear to myself. But that's it. Like, and I love his podcast career, by the way. But go ahead and say what you're going to say.
I respect that. For me, y'all put down a list. For me, I decide I'm just going to go off the top of my head, because I feel like, and you guys probably feel this way too, and our listeners, I'm sure, more than likely feel the same way. It's fleeting. Like, it could change at any given moment. It's so much great music out there that we were able to experience throughout the 90s and in the early 2000s, to where it's like, damn, I could say my five, but then I'm leaving another five off of it, right? So I'm glad, though, that you said, like, your top five in terms of who you listen to the most, not necessarily who you feel is the best or,
like, right now,
you know, lyricist or artist or whatever it is, right? So off the top of my head, it's a trifecta, so we all definitely gonna say Jay-Z. The man is, in my opinion, the absolute best that there is, just from stage presence in terms of like his shows. He's not, you know, animated like a lot of the other artists are, but just the way that he carries himself and the stage sets, the outfits that he has, the props and all that, he is one of the best when it comes to putting on a live show, right? And just his catalog, I don't think anyone can match that catalog for doing it as long as he's done it and having the success throughout it. And for him not being a big artist and really, you know, as commercial for the beginning of his career, to then having, you know, Hard Knock Life and that Annie sample, and then just taking off and being a, you know, unstoppable force. So Jay is number one in my opinion. Second, I would probably say Kanye, just because I feel like he is one of the greatest artists, not necessarily rapper, but just artists. When you look at all that encompasses Kanye West, of all time, right? From the live shows, to the beats, to the songs, to the lyrics, to the way that he uses his voice, you know, to the fashion, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Like, the fact that he wants you, he puts his all into everything that he does, and he doesn't sleep until everything is perfect. And the fact that he even goes back and reworks, you know, a lot of his music too, after it's already out there, it shows you that he does his best to be, you know, a perfectionist. So Jay, Kanye, third, I'm gonna take it down south and say Currency. I love the lane that Currency has put himself in. You know, he started out with No Limit. I think at first, I could be absolutely wrong. I know he moved over to Cash Money, and you know, he was with Weezy and all them on what was Young Money and all that. And then he carved out his own lane and was able to do his own thing and be super successful at it. I've been able to see him live before. I love his show. You definitely will catch a contact being at a Currency show. Jet so life. Be prepared for that. Yeah, be prepared for that. And he's put a lot of artists on as well. And if you don't listen to Currency, you need to, because just short of Rick Ross, I would say he has probably the best ear for beats. His ear for beats is almost unmatched by no one. So I love Currency. I love the movement that he's been able to create. And he collabs with a lot of different artists, a lot of different producers, and everything that he makes is excellent. And he puts out music nonstop too. So it's always something. You know, you're always going to get something throughout the year from him. So Currency would be number three. Number four, I would say Dom Kennedy. Love Dom. Another one that has a great ear for beats. He's been doing it for a long time. I love the fact that, you know, he never decided to go the major label route and was able to create his own label, OPM, and put a bunch of people on. And all his people got projects this year. He just came out with a couple things already this summer over the last couple months. And like you said, Nas has done it his way. Dom has definitely done it his way and hasn't had to, you know, buy into the big money machine. And he's still been able to be successful and relevant all these years. And I've been able to see him live a number of times. And he has a tremendous following, not just in, you know, L.A., Southern California, but all over the world. He's been able to tour all over the world and all over the country. So Dom will be number four. And number five, I'm going to actually go with a group. So I'm going to go with, and it was tough for me. It was between De La Soul and A Tribe Called Quest. And just for the simple fact that De La's stuff is not on streaming services for some legal reasons, right? And Tommy Boy actually wants to put them on streaming services, but I guess a lot of their samples aren't cleared, so they don't want to get into this long, drawn-out legal battle, if I'm correct. So I'm going to go with A Tribe Called Quest. Everything that they've ever made is awesome. And for them to take as long of a break as they did and then come out with the album that they that they put out while Fife was dealing with his health issues and be able to finish that right as he, you know, was unfortunately suffering his decline. That album is great. And they had a lot of current artists on there and was able to make some great music. But just the way that they came into the game and then the way that they, you know, exited the game, the things that they've been able to do from a, like, branch off as well, Q-Tip on his solo thing, Q-Tip making beats for Nas on his first album, Ali Shaheed Muhammad doing Lucy Pearl and a bunch of beats for other people, and then Fife having his solo career, like, A Tribe Called Quest is one of the best groups in music, period, not just hip-hop, not just rap, in music, period. And their catalog speaks for itself. A lot of memorable beats, rhymes, and life from them. So that's my five.
Hey, that was a solid list right there, man.
Solid.
That was random, but I could agree. Like, like I said, these could change at any moment. I know I was thinking about Outkast. I was thinking about it, like a gang of people could be on that top. And I know Kendrick was a close, and Kanye were close too. Like, they could replace anybody on the top five. And the funny thing, like, about Biggie, like, I know Andy mentioned Biggie. Like, I love Biggie as well. I think I was just late to the Biggie train. Like, I 98, 99, like, when I started listening to him, I listened to him, but I didn't really search for him. But when I found out, like, how great he is or what they considered great, then I, like, listened to him. And I'm like, oh, okay, I can see what they're saying. But I have no emotional connection. Unless it's, like, that 112 remix. Like, you know, but, like, I love that song. But I listened to Bottles Up the other day, too. And I was like, damn, they had 112 on there, too. I was like, damn, this is a dope album.
But that's funny because when you say you go back and listen, and when Levins was talking about Jay-Z, we all talked about Jay-Z, I think his 444 album is similar. So if somebody goes back and listens to it, I just did a couple weeks ago, and obviously this came out 2-3 years ago. He was really schooling us on power, and like your own enrichness and your own education, your own pursuit of like just knowing exactly who you are and what you're capable of.
Yeah.
And then like not settling, and in his own trials, like from his personal trials, like he obviously spoke about his relationship, and then business wise, like I listened to it and I'm like, yo, he's talking about like doing dumb stuff when he was young and like how it could have turned out better, but this is his life now, and like, you know, but he's schooling us, like. And so I just feel like sometimes we need to go back and listen to these artists and like really listen to the stories they're telling us, because they could teach us a lot just through their experiences. So I just thought about 444, like that was a crazy album. What was that?
JB having gems, like all you have to do is buy the album and he's giving you millions of dollars worth of advice and insight and gems, you know what I mean? And
that Dumbo line,
just to exactly right, ownership, real estate. And just to go back to the whole, like, this could change at any given moment. The whole time I was thinking, I'm like, say DJ Quick, say DJ Quick, say DJ Quick. And I didn't say him, right? So that's why it's like, there's so much great music over the course of the last, you know, 30 years, for sure, 20, 25 years, that you could really, you know, speak on. And the fact that I forgot to mention him, even though he was like the number one, number two person that I was going to mention, just speaks to, you know, hip hop and its longevity.
Yeah,
that's true. And hey, King, back to that too. King Kunta is, I mean, To Pimp a Butterfly, that album is.
And that album, the way it aged too. So yeah. There was a, myself included. So I didn't really like it when it first came out.
Correct.
I have some friends who really didn't like it when it came out. And it grew and it grew and it grew. And I think what really helped it grow is the things that he was speaking about were the things that were going on in society, especially for Black people, the Black man, and which really has been going on forever, right? But we started to see it happen more and more frequently. And it's like, ah, this is what he was talking about. So it was a lot of social commentary that was going on. And it was right in front of our faces, but we weren't picking up on it. So yeah. You go back, you know, 3 years after it's released, and you like, man, okay, I'm in tune. I know what's going on. I know what he's saying and everything. So now that makes that album even better than what it was.
That's the same thing with 808 and Heartbreaks. Like, I didn't like it when it first came out, and that thing aged so well. Like, you just dropped that on.
And Yeezus too.
Yeezus too, yep.
Nah, but it just has a lot to say to do with our society. Like, we don't like change, and it takes us a long time to even accept change. And so these are artists that were doing something totally different, and now it's like Picasso art, beautiful art, right? Thousands or hundreds of years later, like it's renowned as like some of the best you know, pieces of artifacts that we have. So imagine 200 years from now, we listening to Kendrick, like, who is this guy? What was he talking about? Listening to Kanye, like, yo, he was really hurt. Is this a definition of feeling hurt? You know, we're going to go be able to go back, but we're living through it now. So we, just like some things appreciate with time, music will appreciate with time.
Yeah,
that's true.
And two things about that. So to stay on Kendrick, number one, I think that album ended up winning a Nobel Peace Prize. No, damn, is what won him. I think a Nobel Peace Prize for that album, right? But he could have just as easily won it for To Pimp a Butterfly. Mm-hmm. The second thing is the fact that Macklemore won Best Hip Hop Album over I think it was Good Kid, Mad City.
Was it Good Kid, Mad City?
I think it was. I'm not sure.
You're probably right, because Macklemore.
But it don't matter what album it was. It could have been Poopity Scoop from Ye. And Macklemore should not have won Best Hip Hop Album over that. Like, that's crazy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I saw Macklemore in concert too.
You would.
He was dope. Hey, but side note, before we move on to, we're going to do Read the Rap, our favorite segment. But speaking about stuff aging well, have you guys watched a movie that you guys were really, really into as a kid and rewatched it as an adult and it's horrible and you never got that same experience?
Tons.
I watched Demolition Man. I was into that movie. I love that movie. Oh my goodness. When I was on a plane, I was watching that movie and I could not get, it started buffering. I was like, thank you. Cause I don't want to watch this no more. My heart was hurting. I wanted to get into that fetal position. I used to watch that movie all the time. And I think just as a kid, a superhero and how he is and Wesley Snipes was dope. I think it was just good, but man, that did not age well. Nah. Have you guys ever had that, like a movie?
For me, probably two Arnold Schwarzenegger movies. So,
Kindergarten Cop.
Kindergarten Cop is a jam. Probably, what's it called? Last Action Hero.
Okay.
Was not good. I still love it to this day, but it's not a good movie at all. And then this is a cult classic, and I would not consider it a great movie, but I still love this movie, Total Recall.
Yeah.
Love it, but it's not that great of a movie.
Yeah. I can't. I was worried as a kid when I saw three boobs.
I can imagine.
All right, we're going to do Read the Raps.
Yeah. Read the well, what Andy? What?
Oh, my bad, Andy. My bad, Andy.
I don't think I have any, to be honest with you. I can't think of any off the top of my head. Nah.
But
when you say Arnold Schwarzenegger, I thought about Jingle All the Way.
Oh, I mean, that's still funny. It's not that good of a movie, but it's funny.
You know what movie? Like, me and Andy used to watch Apocalypto. That movie was
Jaguar. I am Jaguar.
That movie aged well. I watched it again. I was like, okay, this is still good. But some of those movies, man, I have a whole list. That could be a whole topic.
Wait, and shout out to Andy and his braids, his cornrows, for telling us before we start recording that he and his wife just started watching Insecure. Can we get a round of applause?
Oh yeah.
Thank you, Andy, for...
Andy can't help you.
That warmed my heart, and I'm glad you on with us.
I'm late to the party.
Jesse and I are TV fanatics, so we're going to start putting you on to some more shows.
For sure. I'm with
it. I've been dry right now. I've been Fargo. So dry. Fargo? Okay.
Fargo.
All right.
Blood? I've been over here watching 90 Day Fiancé.
Oh, 90 Day Fiancé? Oh, I'm an addict.
But is Lovecraft, because I try to watch it. I haven't tried to watch it, but I see memes and it says, would you try to explain what Lovecraft is about? And it has that guy, how you burn a
I would never be able to describe Lovecraft to you ever. See? But it's good. It's good acting, okay. Good writing. The lube scene was very disturbing. The high heel scene was very disturbing. And I don't see myself watching those scenes ever again. But the show itself is
good.
I love it.
I'm into watching The Boys right now. I don't know if you guys watched
I've heard it's great. I haven't watched
The Boys before. Is an amazing show. I know Andy's not really into the superhero thing. Mm-hmm. And it's not really all into that superhero, but it's kind of cool because I don't want to go too in-depth. But it pretty much shows how superheroes in today's society will benefit from people, right? Like one company owning the superheroes, getting like endorsements, having their own shows, like trying to get military contracts, like owning them as a business. And it's pretty cool.
They're pimping them.
Yeah. It's an amazing show, but I've been on that. That's a really good show. I have about four more episodes to catch up. I wanted it to like smooth through. You know, your boy watches anime, Food Wars, watch it. But anyways, Read the Rap.
All right, let's get into this Read the Raps.
Let's go.
Who's going first?
Andy.
All right, so Jesse sent me his, so I'll be reading Jesse's. I'll just start off. All right. When I catch you looking at the glist of my hands and the wrist while I'm laying back smoking on a cannabis, when it's when it comes to rocking the rhythm like Marvin and Luther, I could tell you when I'm messing with Can Man, the twist and the chai, and I be sipping Hennessy, play some R&B while I smoke a bleep. You can preferably find I'm a G, well, and all this, well. Come with me and sip on some Evelyn champagne. You ain't no twister, could work it like the whispers. Hit the stoplight, move it to some Isaac. His rims still moving, so I bump like spinners while I be smoking on that bee dipping through the streets, bumping R&B. I got the leaf on the 23s, and I do it with my earth, wind, and fire. Let me smoke on your sheets, sweat, listening to Key Sweat, put you in a daze with the maze, fur filling with every temptation, slow jams, having deep sex. You ready for the world, girl? Baby, come on, go with me. I touch you all around your body. Baby, don't say it to me in every moment controlling me. I love the way you be holding me. I be listening to Jodeci. When I come around, bend your ass, and you be bumping Teddy Pendergrass. I done hit it from the back to the melody and wrote it slow. Now I go up and fast, but I'ma finish last. No matter how much of a thug you see, I still spit that like R&B. Come to the club with me when... When some Luther come on, I hope you feeling me and still be in love with me. Is that Twista? What was the name of that song with Kanye?
Overnight Celebrity.
Overnight Celebrity.
Oh, that's which one it is?
Uh-huh.
Okay. I knew it was one.
I knew it was Twista because I was like, I'm not saying this right. There's no way.
How did he rap that so fast?
I don't know. I couldn't even read it that fast.
He's won like Rap Olympics for his rapping so fast at the speed.
That's great. You gonna go? You want me to go?
I'll go.
Go ahead.
All right. Beef is best served like steak. Well done. Get a gun to your face. BN, which stands for buttered nicely. Beef will have you praying to God. Move your kids. Have you hiding your mom? Beef is when you hide behind them other necessary people. But they ain't killers. They ain't pulling them triggers. F, as in frankly, nicely. Beef will have you keying our cars. Heart broke, yours don't look like ours.
What is it?
Hey, that was short.
Yeah, I just hit the 16.
Yeah, it was short. Short. That's... Notorious B.I.G. was Beef?
Nah,
it's or close. Am I wrong?
Yeah, you're wrong. It's a Pusha T Exodus.
Oh, dang. All right. Oh, well. I was wrong.
It's when he was coming at Lil Wayne. Go ahead, Jesse.
When I met you, I admit my first thoughts was to...
Oh, my goodness. No. No, I can't. Nah. Mm-mm. Start over. Start over. You sound like a serial killer.
What? You know what meme I'm talking about, right?
Go get no. me some fries.
No. Hey, right. Say it in your MAGA voice.
Duh!
Wow. When I met you, I admit, my first thoughts was to trick or treat. You look good, huh? I snuck you on yo daddy's pipe. I never felt that way in my life. It didn't take long before I made you my wife. Got no rings, Charles Barkley, and crap, just my main squeeze. Coming to the crib, even had a set of keys. During the days, you helped me bag up them nickels. In the process, I admit, I tricked a little. But you was my girl, the one who would never snitch. Love me when I'm broke or when I'm filthy, filthy rich. And I admit, when the time is right, That wine is right, Camus. I treat you right. You talk slick, I'll beat you right.
I don't even know who that is.
Wait, is that the end of it?
Yeah, that's okay. The end of it.
I don't know who it is?
Heck no.
Andy, do you know?
No.
Biggie, me and my B.
Oh, shoot. That's
I can hear his voice now. Biggie's voice.
Oh, you heard it? I did good?
Wait, speaking of MAGA, we didn't get on the fact that y'all's boy, well, Jesse's boy, came out the hospital after dealing with COVID or whatever, right? And this man said catching COVID was a gift from God, a blessing in disguise. We won't get into it, but just the fact that he said that. Crazy. Well, and you support him.
No, I do. Why am I stopping that on me, man? Well, the good thing that word on the tweet was.
What was
that?
It?
This just in. The Taliban endorses Trump.
That's wild, bro.
Okay.
That's so first wild. First, it
was Osama bin Laden's niece. Now it's who?
Taliban. Yeah. Endorses them, saying like, you know, y'all let us do our thing, but hopefully y'all can move y'all troops. Let us do our thing. Bro. Hey, we like you. We support you. Get in so then you could get out of our country. Pretty much. We got your back.
They are trolling. That's so, the definition of trolling.
So I was reading the tweets, right? And then this, should I shout her name out? You know what? Just throw her name out there. Her name was Olivia Nuzzi. And she says, in a huge loss for Joe Biden, Donald Trump gets a crucial Taliban endorsement.
That's major.
Oh, my God.
But then I think she was just trolling because then, and then right after she says, this comes after Trump was also endorsed by the coronavirus a few weeks by the Biden campaign.
she had to have been trolling.
Oh, man. The comments are just funny.
Twitter is free. The fact that Twitter is free and people on there be everything is jokes. Even the one that I sent y'all earlier to where the dude was like, I got a job interview coming up tomorrow. And the problem is I thought it was going to be over the phone, but it's actually a Zoom call. And I took Twitter's advice and said I was a Caucasian man. And the dude is black. Oh, so he was asking people like for advice on what he should do, and all these like white guys in their 50s started responding to him.
You saw O'Reilly?
Yes. O'Reilly responded?
No, not him. That was the guy's name.
That was funny, man.
That was hilarious. Twitter.
That's just
is
funny
free.
How one thing could just blow up like that.
I know. Twitter
you ever blew up like that?
Me? No.
You ain't never I'm said not that. That.
It's a matter of time, though. If you follow Blevins, he's always talking on there, talking his mess.
Blevins got me back on there. I'm out there just looking, laughing. Twitter seeing what's trending, just laughing. But yeah, Twitter is great. We need Twitter, to be endorsed by Twitter.
I think Twitter is overtaking IG. Am I mistaken by thinking that?
Twitter. So I think what Twitter launched first in like 2008 or something mm-hmm. like that.
And don't it disrespect was MySpace.
The greatest thing ever. And then you had Instagram came along in what, 2011?
10, 11.
Something like that. Mm-hmm. Or started being popular. Yeah, 2010, 2011, somewhere around there. And then, like, that was the thing, right? And it still is. But then now people, you know, have kind of shifted back over to Twitter. But, it, you know, it's this difference. It's like, if you want content and you want engagement in terms of like interaction and, you know, responses and stuff like that, definitely Twitter. But if you want like, you know, things that are quick and, you know, visual, it's Instagram. But then the comments on Twitter are a lot more harsher than they are on Instagram. A lot more. So you can get your feelings hurt for sure.
Okay. And you can't take it back either.
Exactly.
You live with it.
Exactly.
Forever. You take it to the grave. All right, y'all. Let's get into some weekly spins.
Hey.
Ooh, I don't even know what did I buy?
What didn't you buy?
Right. Exactly.
Shout out to GLK. I got the Make Dope Art hat.
I do like that. That is fire.
GLK. Shout out. That's from the desert. 760.
Yeah, 760IE. So, you know, he's always showed support of us. So, you know, always right for us to show, you know, respect for him and show some support.
Black owned.
Black owned.
Let's go.
Man, he used to give us free shirts all the time for our show just to support him. And we used to rock him. Like, he had some great stuff and he still has great stuff. So check out his stuff.
Is he going to send us, meaning me as well, some stuff? a care package?
Hey, I'm sure his business has grown where he might be able to do that. You know, I feel sorry for him, like, you know, starting up back then of how much shirts he gave us for free. So I'm going to pay him back as much as I can. So definitely support the movement. A lot of great stuff. Check out his website. A lot of great merch. I also...
What's his Instagram handle? Do you know?
GLK Clothing, isn't it?
Yes.
There we go. Andy, look at Andy with the save.
I was going to have Andy put it right here.
All right.
He still will.
You could put the quick link. And then obviously you guys know I did my Invisalign. I actually cracked one of my tooth and I had to get another one here. So I got to get two caps. So that cost me about 11 hundo. Man, so that was unnecessary spins. But your boy got a new tooth. You can't see it. He got a new tooth.
GLK Clothing Co. Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. What's up? What about you, Blevs?
Me? Oh, man. So
Do I have a little drum?
No, nothing. I was adulting last week, and it was, or the week prior.
What the heck?
I was adulting, and what I say was a bunch of car stuff I had to take care of, some yard stuff, and now we go to the inside of the crib, and we're getting new floors. And it is expensive. So
money. He got money.
No.
He got money. He got money. Hey.
All right, so you getting
is that a slot machine or something?
Yeah. You getting marble floor? Huh? Marble floor?
Nah, I ain't got.
He said I got tile, and I was like, "What'd you get? Moroccan tile."
Anyway, no, we got some tile, some porcelain tile with a polished finish. But the what do you call it? Money. The design looks like wood, so it's really dope. And I'm like, you know what? Yeah, it costs more than, you know, vinyl, luxury vinyl, or what is it, laminate. So let's go ahead and do it. I'm like, all right, cool. So I go and buy all the stuff, bring it home. The gentleman that's going to install everything, shout out to Alberto. Maybe he
might
listen and give me a discount or something. He picked up the material and then dropped it off. And then, so I was okay with what the extra price was going to be. Then he was like, you're going to need new floorboards too. So I'm like, all right, how much is it for the labor? So he tells me the labor. I'm like, cool. He was like, but you also need the floorboards themselves. Then he tells me how much that's going to be. Then he tells me how much I need to pay for the mortar, then the grout and all this stuff. And I'm like, damn, this is way, way, way more than I had anticipated, but it's too late now. It's too late now.
So you spend money.
Weekly spend. They breaking me. My pockets are broken.
Being a adult is overrated. All you do is spend money.
Exactly.
Especially when you're a homeowner. So I feel both of you guys right now.
Yes.
I'll be there soon, one day.
With Andy, you guys. What you got?
You own like 80 homes
before. Before, not like, no more.
Okay.
Not no more. Don't not matter. Right now, at least. Not right now, at least. I copped it before, but I just got it in. And it was when the Lakers won the Western Conference, I got a t-shirt and the hat. So I got that in.
The official ones?
Yeah, the official ones from the NBA. And I didn't want to wear it yet because I was like, yo, I can't rock this if they don't win the championship. So it's still in the plastic. I'm going to hold on to it until they win because I just don't want to. That's not what we celebrate. I won't celebrate it until we get the final, until we win the finals.
Are you going to buy a finals one too?
Yeah, I'm going to be looking for that link as soon as it comes out. I got to, man. Just 10 years removed from us winning one. I got to get something. So,
yeah.
What else did I buy? I think I bought my daughter some merch, YouTube kid merch. So it wasn't JoJo even Sawa? For myself. Huh?
JoJo Sawa?
No.
Or Seward, however you say her name.
Bro, there's so much stuff out there. It's like, it was Lanky Box. I don't know if you guys know Lanky Box. Yeah, never see. So I bought her some merch. Other than that, I was looking to my purchases. I really don't got nothing. That was it. Those are my two things.
Okay.
So the next day, we went to Chicken Filet, some place in the mall. When I got there, I was like, bitch, where are all these people out here? She said, well, it's the mall. I was like, whatever, bitch. Give me a chicken sandwich and some waffle fries.
Is Tyler the creator?
No. That's why I was talking. That's what I was talking like that.
Better give it some.
Oh, it sounds like fries. Tyler the creator.
All right, let's get that vibe right now. Blev's just shaking his head. He's like, oh.
One day Blev's gonna leave the podcast because of you.
B, I was just trying to explain what I was, my thought process was. That's all.
Jesse, we need to see.
Like a serial we need a killer.
We need a video of you dropping off your ballot.
We need and we need to see who it is that you bubbled in.
What about my right to be protected? And
as long as you don't put it on social media, it's okay. But you owe us.
Put it in the chat.
We need to know. No, don't put. What? What is that?
I'm bad.
What is that?
Is it sticky notes?
No, it's a Michael Jackson album that Aubrey drew for me.
Oh, okay. That's got an artist. Okay.
Yeah.
Future Weekly Spin.
Mm-hmm. All right, Abe, what you got here? 53 Thieves?
We are going on to Vibe or Not. And yes, 53 Thieves. I think I sent you guys this album and I've been listening to it. I sent it to some more friends as well. So it's just some R&B, some listening, some music, really good album. Never heard of them, so first time like really listening to them, and I really enjoy this song. It's called 3 AM.
After Hours EP 53 Thieves 3 AM.
See, gets you in the vibe.
Give me something.
With
the lights left on.
New grill. Grill alert.
For me, darling.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a vibe.
I like that, man.
Yeah, you got, hey, the whole album is like that. Yeah, listen.
I'm going to have to check that out.
Yeah.
You know what?
That one.
It's been difficult because I got y'all that be just sending stuff. Then a bunch of stuff came out. I think it was either last week or week before. So some other friends sent, like, it was the week to where it was literally like six different projects came out. So they sent some stuff. A couple other friends have been sending stuff. I'm like, it's really difficult to be listening to all this new music.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, catch up.
Yeah.
Okay. What about you, Blevs?
I just heard this song and I love it.
I heard it this morning.
By Anderson .Paak called Jewels. And I don't know if you know, you said you heard it, but I don't know if you know, Timbaland produced the beat.
Dang.
One of my favorite producers ever.
Have we told the story that we saw him live on
here?
Nah. Yeah. So me and Andy were able to see him when early in his career, but he still had a great following. And that man, like I said, I swear I've said it, like, this guy would play the drums and sing at the same time. Like, that's just crazy. So I've always had
talking about Anderson .Paak, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I thought you were saying, I'm like,
Anderson. All right, but Timbaland made this beat?
Yeah.
All right, let me see.
Nigga had the proof point. Hold up, I ain't even put my jewels on.
Okay.
Dance to this one too, Jesse.
I was about to karate chop one.
You said karate chop.
Every time, like, I'll it's funny because I'll be like, all right, maybe I'm just going in a different vibe. Let me go, like, towards their vibe. But I listen to a lot of different music too. But it's funny because all the stuff you guys played was stuff that I would have sent. so that I would be the hip hop guy
today. Let's go. Rugged.
So dinner party dessert. This one is going to be Freeze Tag featuring Cordae.
YBN.
Drop the YBN. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Because he's with Naomi Osaka now. He can't be having that. I've been waiting on the summer. So
look at me. I was searching through my archives, reminiscing car rides, thinking about how far I had come like since a small fry. Fortunately, I lost ties with niggas that had cross sides. Unforgiving creates division like a park.
Next week, we're going to break down one of Andy's songs. Lyric from lyric. It might be repetitive, but guess what? We can't get hit with copyright because we did it. And he's here.
And correct me if I'm wrong, but does Cordae remind you of Chance the Rapper?
Not me.
No.
No.
No. I think he will have a, I don't want to say better career, but I feel like his projects that he brings out will have a better reception.
The reason why I say that, I just don't want him to be Chance the Rapper. Because Chance the Rapper, I think, was going to be somebody that we all would hope for him to be, and he hasn't panned out that way. And Cordae, his first album reminded me of Chance's debut album, as far as like impact wise, like super amazing album. So I want his follow up album.
Which one are you talking about? Album or mixtape?
Not the acid one, but the other one. I forget the names of both albums right now.
Coloring Book. That was a quote-unquote mixtape as well, though. Mm-hmm. Then when he came out, so it was. Coloring Book was great, acid rap. And then even his stuff that he did with Jeremiah, the holiday albums that they did, fire. But then when he came out with his actual official album, didn't move.
Yeah. But I like Cordae. I think he could potentially.
Now his project was fire.
Yeah, no, for sure. I mean, and he could be the future of rap. Like, he could be, I mean, he'll be his own lane, but he kind of reminds me also like a J. Cole, because J. Cole progressively got even better. And his, you know, he's always been good, but he got better.
Yeah, yeah. So, and created his own brand, too.
And he's hooping for Detroit Pistons next year.
And got the Pumas.
Is he for real?
No, that was great marketing. It might give him a jersey.
I'll get him. I'll call him real quick.
You seen him dunk at the All-Star game?
Yeah, he barely can.
Yeah.
I dunk like that to this day. I dunk like that to this day right now.
You what?
I could dunk like that to this day, and he has like 3 inches on me. Hey, so I went to go play basketball last week in a gym, and it's pretty crazy. So you have to check your temperature when you get in, and then you can only have a select person. You have to go with a group, like the people you know. You can't just go play pickleball. So it has to be like the select few, right? So anyways, I was playing with some guys, and I didn't know some of the guys, but they're over there calling me strong legs. They're like, oh, look at them strong legs. I was like, nah, man, I'm old, man. I was like, I'm old. Ain't played in 6 months, man, but we getting it.
Okay.
I want to see Blevins play. You still got it, though?
Defense, that's all I could do. But as soon as I get 5 minutes, so
Blevin is the real defensive player of the year.
Yeah, give me that.
Call Danny Green. All right, I'm gonna end it with a beat that I sent you guys a couple days ago.
Your Twitch beat, the beat you did on Twitch.
Oh, you want that beat?
Is that this not that one?
No, you didn't hear this one.
I heard it. That's what I thought it was.
No, this ain't the Twitch beat. I haven't even exported that Twitch one yet.
This reminds me of some Timbaland type stuff too.
Or Pharrell.
Yeah. You know what it kind of reminds me of? Remember that Nike Air Force campaign that they did with Just Blaze did the beats?
Jewels was on the song.
Yeah. That's what this kind of reminds me of.
Hey, the hook reminds me of like when you're going into a liquor store and the door is opening. You know what I mean?
None of my liquor stores doors open. We have to open it ourselves.
Like, no, like when you go in, it's like ding dong. Like, watch, I'm gonna let it play before we get out of here. It's just like you open the door.
Oh, the sound that they make.
And the sounds, watch. It reminds me of that. Did you guys hear the end of this? I'm gonna play it after the thing. Like, you hear the end of this when it switch?
Yes, I listened to the whole thing.
See, this doesn't sound like you're opening your welcome.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I hear it. Didn't we all drop a 16 on it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Y'all have me right to it.
Yeah, Blevins dropped that 16.
Always rapping. I always send you guys 16s when I'm bored.
Which is every day.
Thank you, everyone, for listening.
Which is every day. I ain't bored every day.
Thank you. Make sure you guys subscribe. Follow. We're trying to hit to 100 followers, right?
100 followers. Yo, we at 93?
Yeah, let's get it.
We on the way.
Tell your friends to tell a friend to tell your best friends, mama's cousin's best friends, third 92. Sister's cousins that live next door but didn't have a hernia. But then you went upstairs and saw a friend and you told them, and then they told two more people.
GLK holler at us.
Hey,
GLK holler at us. Send us something.
Yeah.
If Andy can't help you.
Saiga, don't burn my hot dogs.